The Pacific Plate, Earth's largest tectonic engine, grinding, colliding, and reshaping the planet. In recent years, it's been stirring in ways scientists can't ignore. Megaquakes off Kamchatka, silent but loaded faults in Chile and Cascadia, swarms in Alaska, and sometimes the shaking doesn't just end with earthquakes, it wakes volcanoes. But what if these events aren't separate? What if the Pacific Plate isn't just shifting the ground, but also holding the power to awaken one of Earth's biggest sleeping giants? The ground beneath our feet is never still. But lately, scientists say something feels different. The Pacific Plate, Earth's largest slab of crust, stretching across nearly a third of the planet, is stirring in unusual ways. Megaquakes, eerie silences, and volcanic awakenings are appearing across multiple edges of the Pacific Rim. And here's the unsettling truth. These events may not be isolated accidents, but connected signals of a larger shift. The question isn't if the Pacific Plate will break again. It's where and how soon. And the first region scientists fear may be closest to snapping. It sits just off America's coast. Just off the Pacific Northwest coast lies one of Earth's most dangerous sleeping giants, the Cascadia Subduction Zone. For over three centuries, this fault has stayed silent. The last time it broke, in the year 1700, it ripped with such force that the earthquake reached magnitude 9.0. The tsunami it triggered raced across the Pacific, striking Japan thousands of miles away, with no warning at all. Now, scientists say the clock is ticking again. Every century, stress builds as the Juan de Fuca Plate grinds beneath North America, and with more than 50 million people living from California to British Columbia, the stakes could not be higher. In September 2025, Cascadia stirred slightly, a 5.8 quake off Oregon, followed by tremors hours later. Minor to most, but for geophysicists, they were reminders that this fault is not asleep, only waiting. If Cascadia ruptures again, experts warn it could unleash one of the largest natural disasters in US history. Cities like Seattle, Portland, and Vancouver could be hit within minutes, followed by a tsunami swallowing entire coastlines. And Cascadia isn't alone in its silence, because to the south, another subduction zone has stayed unnervingly quiet, and history says it's overdue. Along the northern coast of Chile lies what scientists call a seismic gap, a stretch of fault that hasn't broken in far too long. History is clear. In 1868, this region produced a magnitude 8.8 quake. In 1877, another struck at 8.5, devastating coastal cities. Then came a century of quiet. Finally, in 2014, a strong quake hit near Iquique, but instead of relieving the strain, it only snapped part of the fault. Scientists warned it was an appetizer, not the main course. Today, geodetic data shows a massive slip deficit still locked in place, enough to fuel another earthquake as large as the ones from the 1800s, maybe larger. For the millions living along Chile's narrow coast, where desert meets sea, vigilance isn't optional. The silence itself is the warning. And while Chile waits for the earth to move, another corner of the Pacific has already begun to rumble in rapid, restless bursts. In March 2025, the Aleutian Islands shook with a swarm of quakes, 8 above magnitude 5 in just 2 days. This wasn't the typical main shock aftershock pattern. Instead, the crust buzzed like a hive disturbed, with multiple quakes striking in rapid succession. For seismologists, that's a warning sign. Swarms can mean harmless chatter, or they can signal stress redistributing across the megathrust. And Alaska's megathrust is no stranger to catastrophe. In 1964, the Good Friday quake ripped through at magnitude 9.2, the second largest earthquake ever recorded. It reshaped coastlines, triggered tsunamis, and left scars still visible today. Could today's swarms be whispers before another roar? Nobody knows for sure. But thousands of miles west, another region has already proven just how quickly whispers can escalate into a monster. Off Japan's southern coast lies one of the most feared seismic zones in the world, the Nankai Trough. For centuries, this trench has produced devastating twin earthquakes, ruptures so massive they can span hundreds of kilometers, often striking in pairs only days apart. The last time a full rupture occurred was in the 1800s. Since then, pressure has been quietly building. But in 2023 and 2024, something unusual happened. Instead of a sudden jolt, part of the fault began to creep slowly, what scientists call a slow slip event. Over weeks, instruments recorded the fault sliding almost silently beneath the seafloor. At first, that seemed like good news. Better a gentle shift than a catastrophic rupture. But the reality may be the opposite. These slow slips often mean the shallow edges are sliding, while the deeper sections remain locked, storing enormous strain. Like a bandage peeling at the edges, it could be exposing the point where the real break will come. Then, in August 2024, a magnitude 7.1 quake struck nearby. For Japan's meteorological agency, it was enough to issue a rare public statement. The probability of a Great Nankai rupture had become relatively higher than usual. That's no small warning. Japan is famously cautious in its messaging, often downplaying risk to avoid panic. For them to break that silence is unprecedented. And the stakes couldn't be higher. Tens of millions live within striking distance. Tokyo, Osaka, Nagoya, Yokohama all sit on soft coastal plains that amplify shaking, and history shows Nankai quakes often generate towering tsunamis that reach land within minutes. The question haunting scientists isn't if Nankai will rupture, but when. And if Japan's fault is showing signs of stress, another region to the north may already have crossed the line. In the remote far east of Russia, the Kamchatka Peninsula is one of Earth's most violent seismic zones. And in July 2025, it delivered a chilling reminder of its power. A magnitude 8.8 earthquake tore through the Kamchatka Trench, one of the strongest quakes recorded in over a century. Only a handful of events in modern history have matched it. But this wasn't a sudden surprise. The year before, a magnitude 7.0 rattled the region. 10 days before the monster, a 7.4 struck nearby. Each time, aftershocks multiplied, as if the fault was reshuffling stress in preparation. Then came the main event, a rupture spanning hundreds of kilometers, releasing centuries of locked strain in one colossal pulse. Shockwaves raced across the Pacific. Over 100 aftershocks followed within just 2 days, including 5 stronger than magnitude 6. The rupture zone was so vast it slightly shifted Earth's rotation. Yet here's the paradox. The tsunami was smaller than expected. Deep ocean buoys measured less than 1 meter. By sheer luck, the slip concentrated in places that displaced little water. Coastal towns were spared disaster this time. But the story didn't end there. Just 4 days later, a dormant volcano named Koryaksky awoke after centuries of silence. Ash and gas burst skyward, leading scientists to ask a haunting question. Did the quake itself trigger the eruption? If true, it's proof that Earth's systems are not separate. When tectonic plates shift with this kind of violence, the effects can reverberate into the magma chambers below, unleashing both earthquakes and volcanic fire. Which raises a larger question. Are these disasters really independent, or part of a single connected story written by the Pacific Plate? So what ties all of this together? Cascadia's tremors, Chile's silence, Alaska's swarms, Japan's slow slips, and Kamchatka's monster quake. All of it is driven by a single force, the Pacific Plate, Earth's heavyweight, moving northwest a few inches every year. It sounds slow, but over centuries, that motion piles up unimaginable strain where the plate collides with its neighbors. Most years, the stress is released in small quakes that barely make headlines, but when too much energy builds up, the release can be sudden and cataclysmic. That's when megaquakes strike. Here's the unsettling possibility. These events may not be separate. Some scientists argue that one great rupture can nudge others thousands of miles away, transferring stress, altering Earth's rotation, even redistributing mass across the planet. Could Cascadia, Chile, Japan, and Kamchatka all be part of the same larger cycle? The science is still unsettled, but the pattern unfolding today has many wondering if Earth's largest tectonic engine is rumbling in sync. And earthquakes may not be the only danger, because when the ground shifts, the volcanoes above often follow. When tectonic plates shift, the effects don't stop at earthquakes. They can awaken the fiery world beneath our feet. In Kamchatka, the 8.8 quake was followed just days later by a volcanic eruption, a rare but chilling reminder that seismic stress can stir magma systems. In Chile, a chain of snow-capped volcanoes towers above the Andes, each fueled by the same subduction forces that drive the quakes below. And in North America, the Cascadia Fault is linked to the Cascade volcanoes, giants like Mount Rainier and Mount St. Helens, looming over millions of people. When the ground rips apart, it doesn't just unleash shaking. It can unclamp magma, destabilize reservoirs, and trigger eruptions. The result? Disasters that combine the worst of both worlds. Earthquake and volcano, quake and fire. Which makes the question even more urgent. Because sometimes, when the Earth shifts, the danger doesn't stop with earthquakes. Deep beneath the Pacific, one scar may hold the key to the planet's biggest hidden threat. And beneath the Philippine Sea lies something few have ever heard of, A scar so vast, satellites mistook it for part of the ocean floor. But it isn't. It's the world's largest caldera, silent for millions of years. But silence is not always safety. Could Earth's biggest supervolcano be waiting to reawaken? The Pacific Ring of Fire, a horseshoe of destruction. 75% of the world's volcanoes live here. So do 90% of its earthquakes. If Earth has a danger zone, this is it. The Pacific plate is under strain. Everywhere, all at once. But what if these quakes are just surface echoes of something far bigger, hidden beneath the waves? Enter Apolaki. Deep beneath the Philippine Sea lies a scar 150 kilometers wide. That's nearly twice the size of Yellowstone's caldera, wider than the entire country of Iceland. For decades, scientists overlooked it. It blended into the seafloor, a vast, circular depression that looked ordinary. But in 2019, high-resolution sonar mapping exposed the truth. A perfect circle, a collapsed dome, a volcanic scar unlike anything ever seen before. This wasn't a random basin, it was the skeleton of a supervolcano, the largest caldera Earth has ever revealed. The world named it Apolaki, after a Filipino sun god. But to geologists, it might as well mean the giant lord. And here's the chilling part. If Yellowstone is America's ticking time bomb, Apolaki is Earth's sleeping giant. So how was this monster born? Rock cores drilled from the plateau tell a story written in lava. 47 million years ago, magma surged upward. Not for days, not for years, but for nearly 20 million years straight. Lava poured across the ocean floor, piling layer upon layer. The plateau grew thicker than Mount Everest is tall, an entire mountain range beneath the waves, and then collapse. The chamber beneath emptied in a catastrophic eruption. The weight of the ocean above pushed downward. The seafloor cracked and caved. What remained was Apolaki. Its floor lies nearly 5 kilometers deep. Its rim rises in scalloped ridges. Its center holds a resurgent dome, proof of later volcanic pulses. It is, by every measure, colossal. But the question that haunts scientists is simple. Is it extinct or only asleep? To answer that, we look at Earth's other titans, Yellowstone. Still alive, its ground breathes in slow motion, swelling and sinking with magma pulses. It last erupted 640,000 years ago, and it will erupt again, Toba, Indonesia. 74,000 years ago, it released 2,800 cubic kilometers of ash. Global temperatures plummeted. Some scientists believe humanity's population nearly collapsed. Krakatoa, 1883. An explosion heard 3,000 miles away. The sky turned dark. Tsunamis killed tens of thousands. And the Gackle Ridge beneath the Arctic. 1 million years ago, it unleashed a submarine eruption so vast it reshaped the ocean floor. Each of these events reshaped history, but Apolaki dwarfs them in scale. So if those giants still breathe, why not Apolaki? For a long-dead caldera to awaken, four ingredients are needed. First, pockets of molten rock must remain. If Apolaki's chamber is fully frozen, the story ends there. Second, fresh heat must arrive, a mantle plume rising from the deep, or an unusually hot slab edge feeding magma upward. Third, tectonic stress must crack open new pathways. And in 2025, we've seen just how powerful those stresses can be. And finally, water. Apolaki sits entirely underwater. If magma meets seawater, the result is cataclysmic. Krakatoa proved that in 1883, and it was tiny compared to Apolaki. Imagine magma surging upward, boiling seawater into superheated steam, explosions powerful enough to shatter the ocean itself. If Apolaki stirred, the ocean wouldn't protect us. It could amplify the disaster. So, is there any sign this could happen? At Yellowstone, instruments detect constant rumblings. At Apolaki, silence. No swarms of quakes, no uplift, no heat anomalies. Most experts believe Apolaki is extinct, its chamber frozen solid. Its fiery age ended tens of millions of years ago. But here's the danger. Apolaki lies in international waters. No seismic arrays sit above it. No satellites track its subtle shifts. Almost no monitoring at all. If changes were happening beneath the Philippine Sea, would humanity even notice before it was too late? Let's imagine the unthinkable. If Apolaki erupted again, the scale would depend on the magma. If it were basaltic, we'd see enormous lava floods. Slow, relentless, altering the seafloor, disrupting ocean currents, killing marine ecosystems for centuries. But if the magma evolved into silica-rich forms, explosions, ash clouds, tsunamis radiating across the Pacific, sulfur dioxide would darken skies. Global cooling could last years. Crops would fail. Economies could collapse. Even if only a fraction of Apolaki's original volume erupted, it could rival the largest disasters in Earth's history. So could humanity survive? Maybe. But civilization as we know it would never be the same. So, should we worry? Probably not. Apolaki shows no signs of life. Its magma chamber is likely sealed and frozen. But its existence is a reminder. Earth has created giants before. It will create them again. The Pacific plate keeps moving west. The ring of fire keeps breaking and burning. Volcanoes like Yellowstone still breathe. Apolaki may sleep forever. But the forces that built it, the same forces shaping our planet right now, are far from finished. From Cascadia's silent clock to Apolaki's buried scar, one truth is clear. The Pacific plate is never still. Quakes and volcanoes are chapters of the same story, and humanity is just learning to read it. If you want to stay ahead of the next shift, subscribe now, because the Ring of Fire's future is far from quiet.